Geminus.AI, who joins me now from Massachusetts. Greg, great to have you on the show. We'll talk about your business in just a moment, but I want to pick up with those comments by the president of Microsoft calling for an emergency break. Do you think there is an urgent need for regulation of AI here?
Issa, I do. I think he's got it spot on. With any new technology, especially big disruptive technologies like AI, we've always had regulations lag behind the development of the technology. I mean, you can think back to the automobile. The automobile was around for years before we had seatbelts and other safety mechanisms. I think in this case, given the pace of technology, we need to get ahead of it. We're not ahead of it right now. I think AI companies are showing that the technology is much more mature than we thought even 6 months ago. So regulation's a good idea. You know, I think that there's a bunch of starting places. We've been talking about data privacy for years when it comes to the internet and social media. This is a great place to apply data privacy, because ultimately AI has to learn from something, and that's data. And so if we can control the ownership of the data and the way AI is trained, it's one way forward.
And then I don't know if you heard the discussion that my correspondent Anna Stewart and I were having about AI and this roadmap they're outlining. We have seen, I think it's fair to say, Greg, quite a few warnings on the dangers of AI and our extinction. But there are huge benefits too. I mean, I remember recently a story on CNN of how a new powerful antibiotic, Greg, that was discovered with AI because he had the means to crunch all this data. Just talk to us about the positives of AI and the ways your company is using it critically.
Yeah, Issa, that's right. You know, I think we're caught up in a cycle where we're really worried about deepfakes and misuse of AI. But on the other hand, as the example you just gave, AI has really big possibilities for humanity. So drug discovery, disease identification is one. In the engineering space where we work, combating climate change is another huge opportunity, right? So Geminus is focused on creating AI algorithms that help large industrials, companies that produce energy, that manufacture things, helping them reduce their greenhouse gas emissions by helping their machines become more intelligent and identify how to optimize themselves.
Yeah, and these, I mean, this is important. This is what we've been doing quite often in my show, focusing on climate change. And the comment that I always hear from our climate correspondent, Bill Weir, is that governments are not doing enough. So developing then these cleaner technologies could really take decades off, right? And they're also very expensive. So how does AI achieve this? Just talk us through for our international audience how this works.
Yeah, Issa, absolutely. So one of the things that AI is really good at is crunching lots of information very quickly and making decisions fast. If you look at the way that humans make decisions, it can take you days or weeks to perform a task that you could get information on with regards to ChatGPT right away. And so that's the same in the engineering world, where decisions need to be made quickly. As an engineer, you might be evaluating how to scale up new technology to produce hydrogen, for example. And it may take you months to come up with an initial design. You have to test that could take years. If you had AI able to help you identify the optimum design to begin with and go through tests and figure out how to scale it up, you might compress that design cycle from 6 months down to weeks. And we see that across the board. You could take something as simple as controlling a drinking water network. Drinking water networks are powered by pumps. Pumps consume 5% of the world's electricity, and pumps notoriously are run inefficiently. So a drinking water network is simply a series of pumps and valves and pipes. And if you were able to, at any given time, identify the optimum amount of electricity to give to those pumps, you might shave off 10, 20, 30, we've even seen 40% energy reduction in the usage of drinking water networks to this type of application.
So give me a sense, Greg, you know, from those companies and from really leadership level, how many are interested in trying to change this, in trying to make a difference when it comes to meaningful difference here, when it comes to climate change? Because you are saying to me, this is realistic, we can change it. But how many companies, how many countries are listening, are paying attention, are seeking your advice on this?
Yeah, that's such a good question, Issa. You know, I think like any new technology, there's a lot of people interested. So we see interest across the board. I mean, there's no company that I could speak to that wouldn't have an interest in doing this type of technology. The question is whether they have the urgency to apply it. And there, at the moment, you're talking about a few global leaders who are doing this. We're dealing with some of the largest corporations on the world right now. And we know that it'll spread, but I think there's a sense of urgency that we need to get to. And you know, our message with Geminus is that AI technology is here. We don't have enough time to combat climate change doing things the way that we used to. So, but there's a disruptive technology that can shave years off the effort and can save trillions of dollars in the process.
Yeah, what is clear is that whatever we're doing is not working. Greg Fallon, great to get your expertise on this. Appreciate it. Thanks, Greg.
Thank you.
Now, when we